We believe, Gerry Brown and I, that there is an upper limit to the mass of a neutron star, which is probably close to 1.5 solar masses. So Taylor's star is very close to that. Not everybody believes us on that. The older ideas, which were first derived maybe in the work by Johnson, Malone, and myself, were that it could be as big as two solar masses, maybe even a little more than that, depending on the equation of state of matter at high density. Well, we think that the limit is about 1.5, and the reason for that is that there is some evidence, not totally convincing evidence, that the neutron star, which was formed in the supernova of 1987A, that collapsed into a black hole. We see no evidence at all of the existence of a neutron star in the middle of the nebula which was made, is left behind by that supernova explosion. Again, not everybody believes that, but I think it is very likely.